today we're taking you around Myeongdong. So right now we're standing outside of exit 6. And yeah, let's go.
So the first thing you'll see coming out of exit 6, besides all the people, is a shopping center called Migliore on your left. They have tons of shops inside as well as currency exchange, but we don't recommend going here because they can have some pretty high exchange rates. Try to find places that are farther away from the crowded areas and maybe closer to embassies, or better yet, get your money exchanged before you come. There's a stage right outside Migliore that always has a seasonal shop or event happening there. Since the weather's getting colder, they have some super cute holiday socks. Look at all of them, they're so cute. And they're cheap too. They're less than a dollar a pair, which is pretty common in Seoul. Myeongdong is considered to be one of, if not the place to shop for cosmetics, but you can find tons of clothing stores, restaurants, and other cool things to see and do here as well. So if you can handle a crowd, come wander through all of the alleys for shopping, shopping, and more shopping. So once you got some shopping out of the way, make sure you check out some of the street food. A lot of them are seasonal, so you'll see things like black bean noodles and roasted chestnuts in the winter, and twister potatoes and maybe shaved ice in the summer. A lot of the stalls will offer the same foods in different alleys, and you can find some pretty filling snacks for a decent price, so you won't be wasting much of your shopping money in order to stay energized for the day. There's a vendor who makes really fine strings, 16,000 of them, by taking a solid chunk of honey and stretching it in cornstarch. They then wrap it around some chopped nuts and form a little pouch of delicious goodness. This particular snack is quite famous throughout Korea, and there's variations of it in other countries as well. If you stayed on the main street that we led you to out of exit 6, you can find the Myeongdong Theater, which you'll see on the left-hand side there. It hosts a variety of festivals, plays, and musicals throughout the year. If you turn left and head down the street, you can also find the Nanta Theater, which puts on nonverbal performances set in a kitchen, and it features a traditional Korean percussion quartet. We were pretty exhausted, so we decided to head to the CGV movie theater on the same street. We bought our tickets and headed straight to the auditorium. Well, that's all for Subway Saturday. If you'd like us to show you more stations around Seoul, please like and subscribe. We'll see you at the next station.